Agriculture Cabinet Secretary Peter Munya says push for changes in management and operations of the tea sector will continue despite opposition from some quarters. While appearing before the Committee on Delegated Legislation, CS Munya said the tea regulations, which have since been stopped by Labour Court, were in the best interest of farmers.
The new tea regulations that were published last month seem to have run into headwinds after the Labour Court suspended their implementation until a case filed by KTDA workers is heard and determined. According to the workers who also presented the submission to the Committee on Delegated Legislations, if implemented, the regulations will not only reduce their wages, but also declare them redundant.
And the major issue for the employees is that the regulations presented put them in a situation where there would be constructive redundancy and a usurpation of the employment contracts.
I'm sure there is a way of settling that, so that if it is blotted, we see how we can take care of obligations of these employees, the way the usual redundancy that government does, you know, but not to say we can ensure that they are permanently, all of them there, earning on a farmer who is making nothing. Surely that cannot be a good argument.
This as KTDA Holding, also appearing before the same committee, faulted the laws, saying they were a private entity, and some proposal, if implemented, would see the agency breach contractual agreements with farmers and might cost them in the long run.
Is that as you regulate, don't impose terms on us. Leave us to do our internal affairs. You regulate policy, because that is what the Crops Act says. It does not give the cabinet minister power to now interfere and take over management.
It is totally misleading to continue calling themselves a private company, unless they have divorced from the tea factories and now they are on their own. If, as they claim everywhere they speak, that the factories own them, and the factories are actually the directors who are directors in KTDA Holding are directors of tea factories, then they are a public company.
Tea factories representative, on the other hand, argued that the proposal to have all teas sold via auction will distort the lucrative markets, further disadvantaging farmers.
We have buyers overseas who buy our tea directly. As mentioned here, that helps relieve pressure on the Mombasa auction. The volumes are reduced. And we have definite buyers who always buy our tea because they want our tea.
However, the agency's efforts to have Parliament abolish the regulations in totality bore no fruits, as members sided with the Agriculture Cabinet Secretary Peter Munya, who was adamant that the regulations are meant to weed out cartels in the key sector.
You are not the ones directing elections of every factory from the Nairobi and therefore determining who becomes director. If a director is not speaking your language, you ensure they lose in the elections. We know those things.
I can assure you where I come from, these regulations, especially one man, one vote, and the limitation of the term of the directors, they are very, very, very popular.
The tea farmers are crying of the monopolistic and over-domineering nature of KTDA. That's a fact you can never run away. You see, if you can't reform yourself, surely society, the government has got a duty to reform, to bring reforms in the tea sector.
The committee urged CS Munya to consider making amendments through consultations with relevant stakeholders to some clauses in the regulations. Benson Ryoba reporting for Channel 1 Business.